Okay, we're back, and we want to take a look now at how good we did with our new improved PRNG. So how good is this sequence it generates? You can see right here that it repeats the 10 that we started with, the seed, and therefore it's going to, from that point on, generate the same sequence, 84960137251, 11, and then get to 10 again. So our improved PRNG is better than our original one. The numbers seem to jump around randomly between 0 and 11, but it's not very good. Notice, for example, that it can't generate the number 12 and that it repeats after a very short time when it hits 10. So this wouldn't be a very good PRNG. This type of PRNG that we're playing with is known as a linear congruential generator, an LCG, because it uses a linear function. PRNGs is a active and important area of research in mathematics and in computer science. And the goal of the research is to find values for A, C, and M, the multiplier, the number we add to the result, plus the modulus. For example, the PRNG used in the Java programming languages, or in some implementations of it, uses this big number for A, uses 11 for C, and 2 to the 48 for M. That means that you're going to have very long sequences of numbers, very big numbers, before the numbers repeat themselves. Going back to our random integer function or block from App Inventor, here's how things work then. Whenever you say, give me a random number, a random integer between 1 and 2, the App Inventor block will call on the PRNG to give it the next number. Now remember, the PRNG is generating a huge long sequence of numbers that are very big numbers like this. So what App Inventor's block does is it takes them, and depending on what you tell it here, it performs its own mod operation on this number to generate a number like 1 or 2. And what you see when you call on this block with 1 and 2 as the arguments is a sequence of ones and twos, as in this example. So that's how a pseudo random number generator works in conjunction with our random integer block and some of our other random blocks in App Inventor. LCGs are not the only types of PRNGs. They have some good qualities. They have pretty good randomness qualities. They're fast and they don't require much memory, but they're not good enough for certain computing operations such as cryptography or encryption and certain types of simulation problems. And for those applications, stronger PRNGs are used. So to sum up, a PRNG is a computational model of randomness. As such, it's an abstraction. It's a simplification of true randomness. Whenever you have a model of something, you can always ask, is it a good model? What would that mean in this case? Well, it would mean, how does it do when you ask it to generate a number in the range 1 to 100? Does it give us a good distribution of numbers? If you use it to simulate a coin flip, is it going to give us a good distribution of heads and tails, 50-50? What about drawing a card out of the deck? Are the odds going to be 1 in 52 that you can draw the ace of spades out of the deck? So those are some of the questions you could ask about PRNGs. In the next lesson, what we're going to do is we're going to ask this type of question about App Inventor's PRNG. So let's give that a look.